take a listen, of course, take everyone's cards and details.
Dat is nog niet bekend, maar Abu Yaram ook hij daar?
Dat is bekend en
ja, want daar zijn kamervragen over geweest. Dat niet
in Spain, in Crete, in Rhodes, in Cyprus, in Greece, much of France was under the Sharia at one point. So this is not an alien religion. Rather, the Muslims, the Jews...
American lives on the 4th of July. Well, tonight, new reports that he might have been the one killed on the 4th. Here's the image tonight, this ISIS recruiter issuing a message about the 4th. And then there's this, the airstrikes over the weekend, over the holiday. ABC's chief investigative correspondent, Brian Ross, tonight on the reports he might have been killed.
My dear Muslims, until now, U.S. officials considered this British-born ISIS recruiter, Abu Rahim Aziz, a key figure in online calls for attacks on America.
Look to your own actions. Look to your own deeds. Have you done enough?
His most recent message, this posting last Friday about July 4th, on Shalah, a day to remember amongst other days. It was quite a 4th of July, but not as Aziz expected. His fellow jihadists said today he was killed as the U.S. launched a series of July 4th airstrikes on the terror group's home base in Raqqa, Syria. The U.S. today would not confirm his death, but late this afternoon, President Obama announced the U.S. is stepping up its attacks on ISIS leaders and recruiters in Syria, taking off the gloves.
We're going after the ISIL leadership and infrastructure in Syria, the heart of ISIL that pumps funds and propaganda to people around the world.
The president cited the attack on a Muhammad cartoon contest in Texas as the sort of threat the U.S. now faces. The men behind the attack were inspired by, among others, the recruiter Aziz, believed to have been killed on the 4th of July.
Thank you.